So let's start with the 10th example. And what is said in this example? Particles of masses 1 gram, 2 gram, 3 gram, up to 100 gram. So these are the particles of various masses are kept on 1 centimeter mark, 2 centimeter mark. Okay, that is on a meter scale. So that is from 1 centimeter to 100 centimeter. The masses are kept from 1 gram up to 100 gram respectively. And this is the central, this is the central part, 50 centimeter. We have to find the moment of inertia of the system of particle about perpendicular axis through meter scale. So about this axis. Now if you see carefully, so from this axis, 1 gram mass is 50 centimeter away. So moment of inertia will be equal to 1 gram into square of 50 centimeter plus, then at 2 centimeter there will be 2 gram mass. So the distance will be 2 gram mass into square of 49 plus 3 gram mass into square of 48, because it would be at a distance 48, and so on, and the distance will get reduced up to 50 gram mass at 0 centimeter marking, because 50 gram mass will be placed on the axis itself. And the same it repeats for this mass. So 100 gram into square of 50 plus 99 gram into square of 49 centimeter square, then 98 into square of 48, and so on. Okay, so you can see that this forms a pair here. So it will be 101 into square of 50. Here also, if I take 49 square as common, so 99 plus 2 will be 101, plus again the square of 48 can be taken as common, and if 98 plus 3 will be 101, and so on. So it will be up to square of 1 into 101. So here 101 can be taken as common, so you will get this as 50 square plus 49 square plus 48 square, and so on up to 1 square. This is nothing but the sum of squares of n numbers. So by algebraic identities, you can directly learn this proof. The squares of numbers, that is 1 square plus 2 square plus 3 square up to n square, is given by n into bracket, n in a bracket, n plus 1 into 2n plus 1 whole divided by 6, where this addition is up to 50. So the value of n is 50. So I'll substitute this value as 50. So let's take the next page. So the moment of inertia will be equal to 101 into n into n plus 1 into 2n plus 1 whole upon 6. So it will be 101 into 50 into 51 into 101 divided by 6. 2 3s are 6, and then 2 25s are 15. 3 1s are 3, 17s are. So now what I have to do is the multiplication of this whole thing. So first I will multiply 25 into 17. So 7 5s are 35, 3 carry, 7 2s are 14 plus 3 will be 17 plus 1 5s are 5 plus 1 2s are 2. 5, 7 plus 5 will be 12, 1 carry, 2 plus 2 will be 4, 425. Now 425 will get multiplied with 101. So 1 5 is a 5, 1 2 is a 2, and 1 4 is a 4, plus 0 0 0 plus plus 5 2 4 again. So it will be 5 2 9 2 4. Okay, then again I will multiply this by 101. So 1 5 is a 5, 1 2 is a 2, 1 9 is a 9, 1 2 is a 2, 1 4 is a 4, plus 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, plus, plus. Again, 5, 2, 9, 2, 5, 2, 9, 2, 4. So it will be 5, 2, 9 plus 5 will be 14, 1 carry, 2 plus 2, 4 will be 5. 9 plus 13, 1 carry, 2 plus 1 will be 3, 4. So this inertia comes out to be 4, 3, 3, 5, 4, 2, 5. But this is gram centimeter square. So now let's convert this. 4, 3, 3, 5, 4, 2, 5. Gram, so it will be 10 raised to minus 3 kilogram. Centimeter square, so it will be 10 to the power 4 meter square. So the decimal point will be after 7 digits. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So it will be 0.43, I will round it off, kg meter square will be the answer to this question. Thank you.